On an autumn evening, there is no color in the sky, nor any sound, and although we cannot give a definite reason for it, we are somehow moved to tears. A person lacking in sensitivity finds nothing particular in such a sight. He just admires the cherry blossoms and scarlet autumn leaves that he can see with his own eyes. Again, it may be likened to the looks and bearings of a fine lady who has some grievance, does not, however, express it in words, but suffers secretly and gives only a faint clue as to her situation. This has a stronger appeal to one's compassion than if she were exhausting her vocabulary with complaints and made a show of herself wringing out her sleeves. A child, on the other hand, how could it understand this just by seeing her looks and bearings, unless the meaning is explained in detail in proper words? By these two analogies, it should be evident that this is a matter impossible to understand for people of little sensibility and shallow heart. How can such things be easily learned or stated precisely in words? You can only comprehend them for yourself.
From your sleep, the drying of your tears. Today we escape, we escape. Past and get dressed before your father hears us, before all hell breaks loose. Sing us a song to keep us warm. There's such a chill, such a chill. Yeah.
昔はただ花を雲にまがえ、月を氷に似せ、もみじを錦に思いをする類をかしきことにせしかど、今はその心を言い尽くして、雲の中にさまざまな雲を求め、氷にとりて珍しき色を添え、錦に異なる節を尋ね、かように安からずたしなみて、思いうれば珍しき風情は固くなりゆく。